That was Denial of Destiny by Bolt Thrower off of their 1988 album In Battle, There Is No Law. They are a death metal grindcore band, and I hadn't really heard them before, except for like here and there when people would have me listen to it. Just, I swear there's been like some old friends here and there who made me listen to it, but I haven't listened to it on my own before. That was pretty cool. I really enjoyed the overall like feel. It was just like thrash metal, but kind of grungy, really grungy. Good stuff. We're listening to that today because we have two songs in the Thrash Bash from 1988 in competition today. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 14 of the Thrash Bash today, and if you're curious as to what that is, because you're new here, let me fill you in. We took a giant handful of songs from the big four of thrash metal out of their first four albums. Basically, everything that wasn't an instrumental, a cover, or under 2 minutes, and then we cut a couple extras because we had to make it 128 songs. And those songs are all battling in head-to-head competitions until we find out which song is the very best the big four of thrash in the 80s had to offer. Today we have our very first Slayer vs. Megadeth matchup. We'll be listening to Ghosts of War, which was released by Slayer in 1988 on their album South of Heaven. It's not Kerry King's favorite song, he just doesn't like how everybody always wants to hear it performed live. He says, I like the ending, you know, I like the big heavy part, and I always say, let's put the heavy ending at the end of Chemical Warfare and just do the last half, but I could never make that fly. And its competition today is Set the World Afire, released by Megadeth on 1988's So Far, So Good, So What. So far, I haven't loved the songs off of this album. Some of it's been alright, though. This is the first song that Dave Mustaine wrote after he was kicked out of Metallica in 1988. He wrote the lyrics during the bus journey home from New York to California after reading a newspaper when he stumbled upon the word Megadeth, the original title of this song, which means a million dead, the result of a nuclear holocaust. So that's how Megadeth got their name. This song, Set the World Afire. So let's see how Ghosts of War does against Megadeth's namesake. Here is Ghosts of War.
Sons will rise once for gods and sons.
Definitely get that the ending is Kerry King's favorite part on there. That's the best part. The bridge on is pretty sweet. The first part's not bad, but it's definitely not my favorite. Just something they did after the guitar solos. They changed it up in a really good way. It was like some groove, really. Let's see how Set the World Afire stands up. Predating Fallout. We'll be right back. Well, that was probably the best Megadeth song so far. That was actually pretty rad. I really enjoyed all the guitars on that one. The instrumental break was cool. His vocals were actually not terrible. They were pretty good. The third verse was probably my least favorite part, but it still was pretty short compared to the rest of the song. Verse 5 had some really cool like guitar shit going on in the background. I was really appreciating. We're going to give that one to Set the World Afire. I didn't expect Megadeth to defeat Slayer in any capacity, but that was a pretty rad song. I mean, Ghosts of War was alright, but Set the World Afire was a better anti-war song, I guess. Ghosts of War might not even have been, like, anti-war. I guess it kind of is. Like, Slayer, kind of, they say a lot of things, but they aren't really talking about the way they feel. They're just talking about a narrative. So, you know, they're just telling a story. It's just words, really. Got social media if you want to talk about it. There's Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. There's also a TikTok account. If you feel like these videos are a bit too long and you wish they were shortened down, check out the TikTok account. I will link the tournament bracket as well as the tournament bracket down in the description of the video. But if you look down below me here, you'll see the tournament bracket has appeared. And you can type that into any web browser and check it out that way as well. We do have a Venmo and a Cash App. And if you donate $10 to us, we will send you one of these No Ringo, No Life buttons. Just leave an address with that donation. Like the video if you like the video, and subscribe if you haven't already. Share with anyone you know who might be into some thrash bash action, and comment down below with which of these two sweet songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. That's all the thrash bashing we're doing today, but I'll see you tomorrow for some more of that, and some more Pixie stuff. I hope you all have a great night, a fantastic afternoon, a wonderful morning. Thanks for thrash bashing with me. Bye.